Hi, this is Uma Mahesh from CRM1s. In this video, I'm going to explain about the iteration tags in the liquid code in the CRM portals. So the first iteration tag is that for. So for it executes a block of code repeatedly. It most commonly used to iterate over the items in the array or in a dictionary. So for example, in the below code, so I'm doing for I'm looping for all the child pages. So for example, you can see curly brace percentile for the child page is a variable, and in page dot children's page is a object in the CRM portal. So this page dot children, what are the children pages we have, that many number of times it will loop, and if we can process it. And every for loop, it should end with the, there is a tag called end for. It should end with the tag end for. And this for loop, it will support the parameters also. So these parameters can be used or can be used alone or in a combination. So the first parameter is a limit. Okay. So limit, it exceeds the number of the given loops, given number of the items. So for example, in the loop, you have 100 items. If you given a limit as a 10, after 10 loops, it will come out from that for loop. Okay. And next thing, offset. Offset, it will start with the loop at the given number of index. For example, in an array, you have a 10 items. If you given an offset as a 5, after fifth element, it will start doing the for loop. The first 5 elements, it will leave it. So next range, it will define the range numbers for the for loops. And reverse, it will iteration, it will start from the reverse order. So ideally the for loop, it will start from the zeroth index, the default. But if you keep it as a reversed, okay, reversed that parameter, so that it will start from that index in a reverse order. So that is the one of the tag we have in the iteration thing for tag. So next one, we have a cycle tag. So cycle means here, it will loops through group of the strings and outputs them in that order. Okay. So it will loops the output, it will loops through the group of the strings and outputs them in that order they were passed as a parameters. For each cycle is called in the next string that was passed as a parameter is the output. For example, in a for item in items, if you see in the dev class, so we are passing as a cycle red, green, blue, and that item in a dev. So for each item, okay, if you have in items, you have a 5 elements. The first item will be printed as a red color, and second item is printed as a green color, and third item it will printed as a blue, and fourth item again it will start from a red. That cycle that is in cyclic loop, it will trigger until the number of the items you have, and here we have a end. Next thing, table row. So this is the tag should generates an HTML table. So table row tag should be used in the HTML table tag. It must be wrapped open with the table tag and closing with the slash table thing. So for example, here table row, child pages, and page dot children's, and page dot title, and end table row. So this table row tag should be used in the table tag, HTML table tag, and within the table tag, and this table row, how many rows you wanted, that it will loop it in a cycle in the for loop. Okay, so next thing, it will has the parameters, the columns. So you want to, it will detect the how many rows this needs to be generated, should have, and limit it will executes after the given number of the things, and range, it will defines the range of the numbers to loop through. So these are the three iteration tags we have in a liquid template code. One is for, another one is a cycle, and other one is a table row. Thank you so much for watching this video.